Hello and welcome to another Innovation Coffee Break. My name is Alexander Trapp and I'm a product manager for the dSPACE Automotive Radar Test System DARTS. Today I want to give you a brief glimpse into an ongoing development here at dSPACE, testing 60 GHz radar sensors with DARTS. Radar target simulators such as DARTS are a proven technology for testing and validation of automotive radar sensors. They are widely used during development, validation and production of all the radar sensors that are installed in cars to enable automated driving. This is because radar target simulators allow testing in a controlled lab environment in a reliable way with high repeatability. Radars for automated driving are generally working within the 77 and 24 GHz radar bands, but recently radars working around 60 GHz are introduced. These are used for automotive in-cabin applications and comfort functions, but also for non-automotive use cases like security, safety, and general people detection. To reliably test these radars, we have now enabled DARTS to simulate targets in the 60 GHz radar band. And now, let me show you a small demonstration of this. Here you see a radar evaluation board from Texas Instruments that works at 60 GHz. This chip is widely used in the industry for various beeper detection and tracking applications. Facing the radar is the front end of our radar target simulator. This is receiving the radar signal, processing it to add target information, and then transmitting the modified signal back to the radar sensor. The radar then analyzes the return signal and extracts exactly the target information that we have added with DARTS. And all of this is covered by some absorber material to minimize noise from the surrounding. DARTS can be controlled by a Scalexio real-time PC for advanced applications, but it can also be controlled using a JSON API or web interface. Look at what the radar is currently seeing. This is a demo visualizer of the eval board, and the radar is currently operating at 60 GHz. In the moment, we see only some noise because the target simulator is still disabled, so I will switch it on. Here our simulation target has now appeared. Note that nothing else has changed when I activated the target simulator. Just a new, very precise and stable reference target that can now be used to test the performance of the radar sensor. The nice thing with a radar target simulator is now that you can control all the target parameters at will. I can change the distance of the simulated target to 6 meters or 140 meters and then back to 70 meters just by software. And I can also control the Doppler shift of a target to simulate a moving object and freely change the simulation speed to whatever I need for my test. And with the last test parameter, also, the radar cross-section of a target can be controlled. This kind of flexible reference target that additionally has a high reliability and repeatability has become a standard tool to bring automotive radars to the market in 24 and 77 GHz. And now these advantages can also be used to bring 60 GHz radars to the market. But these typical target parameters may not be sufficient for all 60 GHz radar use cases, especially for in-cabin applications like child presence detection. A functional test will only be possible if the target shows vital signs. A typical vital sign would be the microdoppler signature of a chest movement due to breathing and heartbeat. As an example, the Euro NCAP protocol for child presence detection specifies that targets with different breathing frequencies must be classified. Adding a microdoppler signature to a target in addition to the previous target parameters can be done by controlling DARTS with Scalexio. And this is how such a target is perceived by the human vital sign measurement demo of the evaluation radar. The radar perceives a very stable breathing rate as well as a heart rate. In this simulation, we have chosen a rather complex microdoppler signature, consisting of these both, and modeled them to closely resemble the vital signs that have been measured for real humans in literature. And in our models, it looks like this. The frequency and magnitude of both breathing and heartbeat can be specified individually. The individual microdoppler signatures are then combined into a superposition of both. Based on this, the simulation parameters of darts are now adjusted to simulate a target with this signature. In this example, breathing and heartbeat were modeled by a Fourier series, but it is also possible to model this with a simple sine approach, or to implement a scenario with different heartbeat or breathing patterns for medical application. This can be varied depending on the application and test cases. Now let's try a different set of parameters. And as you can see, the radar sensor now perceives the changed breathing rate at 27 BPM and heart rate at 98 BPM. In summary, you have seen that the radar target simulation with darts is now also possible for 60 GHz radar sensors. With this, there is now a very reliable reference target available that allows tests with high repeatability, but also with high flexibility to satisfy the requirements of a multitude of different applications. This flexibility allows for very precise static targets, dynamic targets moving according to a given scenario, or even more complex targets that also show vital signs. While these functions are not yet released as a product, we already offer evaluations and demonstrations. So if you are interested in a more in-depth discussion, an evaluation, or just more information, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you for your time and have a great day.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.